bench grinder. My bench grinder is kind of vibrating. I've looked at a lot of videos online on people do-it-yourself balancing and doing different things. And I kind of took a little bit out of each one to try to come up with the ultimate idea of somebody can balance their bench grinder and do it at home. So okay. Let's go look. Here it is. This is a used bench grinder. I didn't buy it new. And I don't know what all it's gone through, but I know this here has got to be surfaced. I can see a lot of little particles in it, and it's not real straight. So I ordered a, I don't know if it's a surfacing tool or what. I'll show a picture right up here. And I ordered that and hadn't got in here yet. But meanwhile, I have checked the grinder, the grinding wheel side, and the wire wheel side, and both of them vibrate. I have taken both of them off and cranked it up, turned it on, and the shaft doesn't vibrate, so the unit itself is okay. But I've checked each one of these by themselves, this one and this one by themselves, and it vibrates. So both of them are out of alignment or out of balancement. Yeah, out of balancement. But I just want to show you how bad it is. I want to take this washer here and set it up here. Let me turn it on. See the table shaking down here? Here too. Right there, it quit moving. But I do have a plan. I got this today from Harvard Freight. I still got the other one coming in. And I have seen somebody use this, and it seems like it does work pretty good. And we're going to see if we can straighten out some of this one and see if we can balance it up. And then also, I have got a plan for both of them. This one first. I'm going to work on it first. And I'm making a balancing, I guess you call it a jig. A balancing jig here, basically. All it is just a... I started with this one board here, and it was warped. As you can see, it's still warped. It's just warped the other way now. And I found these two pieces of metal. I was really lucky to find them. They actually go like this. They are drain catchers or something for a beer dispenser. Yeah, services tap beer. Oh, that just come loose. But anyhow, I mounted these to the board with screws. I mounted this board to a straight board underneath. And then I drilled holes, four holes, one, two, three, four small holes, just enough for the screw to go through. Now the screw goes all the way through to the other side, and I can use it to adjust. See right here? Here, there. Sun's getting in the way, shade's getting in the way, there, and two here. That way I can put it on the table here and take a small level like this one and use a screwdriver. I had it all leveled a minute ago. Use a screwdriver to adjust each one of these to get that bubble in the middle. That away, and this away, which is off now since I've moved it. Now once we do that, I got to get set up on a tripod because I'm going to need both hands. Okay. Alright, you can see the bubble's out. I'm going to adjust this screw here. One of these screws like, well, I hope you can see that. I can't move it. Getting close. Okay. Bubbles in tolerance right there. I'm going to check this front one. That's pretty close. Okay, that's because them screws going all the way down and touching this table. Okay, that's pretty close. I need to check it this way now. Oh, it looks good. It looks good. Yep, it looks good. I don't know if you can see it from there, but it looks. It looks good. Okay, now since we've got it level, I'm gonna work on the brush one. This is a thick, wide brush thing. But you can see a lot of little dingleberries in there where I've been cleaning it up. The dingleberries are stuck in there. I don't know how to get them out, but I know we need to balance it. But I need to find a shaft to go through here. Now this bolt here is a little loose. So what I've done is I found a piece of cardboard here and I've rolled it up and slid it down in here. I've already had it in there earlier. I've already been practicing. I want to make sure I can pull this off and then send the bolt down through there. That way it's right in the middle. Okay. Now I'll set this on here. See it roll? The heavy side is at the bottom. The heavy side is at the bottom. And like I said, I looked at this earlier. And I've already made a little mark right there showing this is the light side, the lightweight side up here. But no matter where you put it, it's going to roll back and that little black mark is going to be at the top. Okay. Now what I've done, I'm going to balance it kind of like what they do, like a car. A wheel, but I'm going to use a little bit of tape, and I got a little bit piece of metal here. I've already had it on there once, and this is just to find the spot that it needs to be, and then we'll talk about how we're going to secure it to it. Yeah, just kind of stick it on there. Now, if this is the lightweight side and the other side is the heavy side, then this weight needs to go up here. Okay, I need to throw it off balance. Make sure this is wide enough when you build it that the brushes are not rubbing up against it. Now this was the heavy side earlier. Now it's showing the heavy, here's my weight and the heavy side right here, even with this bar. But it wants to roll over that way. Let's go to this side and see what it does. So it wants to roll under and come back up over here. So that means my weight needs to move just a little bit downward. Not much. I might have moved it too much even then. See, keeps wanting to pull down that way. Maybe I went the wrong direction. I bet I did. I bet I should have went the other way. Okay, let's go in the other direction. I'm just moving it just a little bit. A little bit one way or the other. Okay, I have moved it one way or the other, and it's pretty close like it is. Now this weight that I added on here, this piece of metal, may not be the right weight exactly. It may need to be a little less or something, or even a little more. This is just a piece of iron. It's not lead like they use on vehicle tires and stuff. That's lead weights. And because lead weights, you can knock off a little bit more to make it a little lighter, or put two of them and knock a little off. You can get your correct weight out, but they're set up to do that. This is nowhere near that, but I'm trying to get it and see what happens. But see, now the heavy side is up here, but my weight's at the bottom. See, now my weight's at the top and the heavy side is at the bottom. So I mean, this is going to be about as close as I'm going to get it. It's not perfect, but it's got to be better than what it was. Now here's my plan. My plan is to take this and mark it where that weight's at. And then I want to take this piece of metal, I want to cut it in two. I want to put a piece on each side. Because that's what they do on a car wheel. They'll put one on each side instead of put it all on one side, because here's your center. Here's the center right here. And if you put it all on one side, you could be throwing it off weight this way. But if you put one on each side, it balances out this way and it balances this way. Then I've got this epoxy here, which is holds up to 1,200 pounds per square inch. That's pretty strong. And I always wear safety glasses when I'm at the grinder anyhow. And so if something should fly loose, I've got safety glasses on. It bonds to metal, glass, ceramic, plastic, rubber, and wood. So that's the plan, is to mark this and cut that in half, put it on each side, and check it again, and then get it ready to glue. Yeah, get it ready to glue. Okay, I cut it in two. I didn't want to use the angle grinder cutoff wheel. So I used a pair of small bolt cutters and just cut it in two. One of them does have a hole, so I try to leave a little more on that side. It's not perfectly, but so now we're going to go back and we're going to put one on each side here. find the center point again of balancement. Okay. That's looking pretty good right there. See how it wants to go back? Now that was the heavy side earlier. See, the weight's there, the heavy side's right here. It's angled this way now. That may be as close as I'm gonna get it. Now, it's right here when the weight distribution is in this area, it wants to go on down. But it tries to rotate back up. So that might mean that this weight needs to go in the other direction just a little bit. Now you might could get a brand new one, you know, wire wheel, and it be off. So you may need to balance it either way it goes. I don't know. It's good to know this stuff. See, that's right in the middle here. Here's the heavy side, there's my weight. And the weight on the other side is just a little behind this one, up that way. That's gonna be about as close as I'm gonna get it, I think. I'm thinking about gluing it there and trying it. And, let me get it ready and then I'll catch you up. Okay, I've got it. And what I did is I took this side and then I took that side and took it to the bench grinder and ground just a little bit, maybe a 16th or less than an eighth, maybe an eighth inch off of the metal, and then put it back in the same spot it was earlier. And now when you move it, it'll pretty much stay there. And that's what I want. So I'm glad I took out the time to go grind each side just a little bit and then tape it back on there. Okay, now the plan is I need to mark it as I move that tape. Yeah, it was about an eighth inch I took off because I marked it earlier and you see the other mark past it over here. Now I don't need to get these confused. This goes on this side. Maybe I need to put an L on it or something. L. Put an L on this one. Turn this around. Mark this one real good. Going to put a R on here. It may not be right or whatever. At least I'll have them figured out. R and an L. Okay. Now what I got to do is remove my bolt, remove my cardboard shim, and I need to carefully grind or clean up some of this rust right here to get these ready to glue. All right, I think I'm set up. I went and got some 100 sandpaper, and I scuffed both areas that's going to be glued right here, and I scuffed the back sides of the little pieces of metal here also, kind of shined them up a little bit. That's got an L, this one's got an R on it. So now I've got my stuff here ready. I've made me a little stir here out of some leftover cardboard stuff, you know, use the back side of this. Put some epoxy down here. It shouldn't take a whole lot for either side. Stir it up real good. You probably know how to use epoxy. Now, I've seen some epoxy at the Harvard Freight that sets up in 90 seconds. And I just didn't think that's going to be enough time for me to do what I'm going to do here. So I didn't get it. I don't know how long it takes this setup. I didn't even read it. Yep, this is the R side. Wipe a little bit on the wheel here too. Okay, and there's my marks right here where it goes. It goes in between those two marks. Now once this dries, I may put some more epoxy around it. That's got to harden. I may just do one side at a time. I got some tape. I could tape it down. But I don't know. I've gone through this much effort. I kind of hate to mess up. Yeah, what the heck, right? That holds it in place because I gotta flip it over. Oh, I can mix up some more epoxy too. I'm not gonna flip it until I get this mixed up. Ooh, too much. Well, I mean, it's coming out everywhere. Flip it over. This is the L. Yep, this is the L side. And I got my marks right here. I got a piece of tape. Yeah, I hope this works because even with a new brush, it could be off balance. You know, and it'd be good to know there's a way to balance it because some of us use a bench grinder or a wire wheel on a bench grinder a lot. To do our work that we do every day. Now I'm thinking about taking this one loose and adding some more because I didn't put near as much on there. Yeah, I probably should have got the 90-second one up there. Okay, I'm gonna lift this one up. I still got my marks there. Yeah, this is starting to get tacky. Yeah, you see where it's getting gummy down there. I'm gonna have to leave it alone. Yeah, see, it's even filled up inside that hole there. Okay, I'm going to get back with you, let this dry, and we'll check it out.
The next morning.
Okay, it's time to find out. I ended up letting this set up overnight just because I had nothing else to do. And make sure it's hard, no excuses. And it's hard. It is really hard. It looks good. Now I had to grind just a little bit here for this to fit in there. Not much, just a little bit. And on the other side, there is a back plate over there that's this size here. So I grind a little bit there. Now I'm ready to put it on there and see how well it's done. Wear safety glasses just in case. Of course, I always wear them when I'm grinding or brushing or whatever, anyhow. Wow. Here's the washer. In there. Okay, I feel good about that. I feel good about that. Okay, the stone. Do something about it. I see it used to be as Black and Decker. But yeah, I see them. You can check a crack. They say, you know, put something in there and listen to it. Okay. But now this one, balancing it, I could do the same thing. But as far as truing it up, I kind of like, some things I grind needs an arch on it. So, still going to do this before I balance it up, but I'm thinking about adding a little more curve right here and leaving it. A lot of people, or they show the videos of a truing it up where it's flat right here. That's all good and fine for doing whatever grinding they need, but most of the grinding I do has got a curve on it. So I'm thinking about adding a little more curve to this. Okay. This is mainly for surfacing. I think it's not going to do anything for balancing, I don't believe. Which we'll check it for balance when I take it off. But I need to surface it first. But I don't want it flat on the end. Because some of the stuff that I make, I need a roll in it down in there. And if I curve the edge here, I could, you know, curve it a little bit more, if possible. Then that'll give me what I want. If I need something flat, I'll go buy a grinding disc that's flat, balance it, and put it on there, and trade them out. But I need one that's curved, to curve down in there, to clean up the welds and stuff. So here we go, safety glasses, ready to go. Whoa, I guess that wasn't tight enough. I gotta find all of them and tighten it real good. I looked at it, but I didn't check it. There's two down in there. There's one there. There's another one. Okay. Camera battery went dead. I'm not sure how much got on there. But this was loose. All these vibrated out. And I found them. I guess I found all of them. And I checked this time. Tightened it good. But I do need this grinding disc to be a little bit beveled or round on one side, because the work I do, I need to be able to clean this up real good in here. And that wheel being beveled will help. If I need one that's flat straight across, I'll go buy one and then I'll balance it up and I'll trade them out. Well, I'll have both worlds. But here we go, safety glasses and all. And I hope this stays on there this time. And I wear something around my nose too. Looking pretty good. I may not have to balance it. Wow, I'm happy with it. I can see dust up around the lens. But anyhow, yeah, it's done good. When that diamond surfacer tool gets here, I'm gonna bevel this a little bit more. It's beveled some, but I like to get it completely round. I wouldn't even mind having the other one round a little bit, because that's gonna help me what I'm working with on this here. That'll help me where I can grind and kind of clean that up a little bit right here. Like I said, I can go buy a flat one, a straight one, and if I need one. Okay, guys, that's it. I hope we both learned something. Only things left is exercise it and practice it and get out there and work on something. Build something today. Have fun. That's what I do. I enjoy building things. I'll catch you later. Bye. Alright guys, tell them where you've seen it at. If you like it, like it. And if you want to stay in touch, subscribe. We'll stay in touch. I'll even go check out your channel. Talk to you later. Bye.